to go clear.
Thanks, it's Korkai Zagirre and Mathieu van der Poel on the Hulpeberg. Mathieu van der Poel, again with such a distance to go, takes off on the attack, and Amstel Gold Race is alive and kicking.
Well, there we go. The chosen son attacks. You know, just riding on pure and utter instincts, urged on by the crowd, who'll be loving every single moment of this, but it's drawn a couple of key riders clear.
Well, that forces a selection much earlier than many people were wondering. Behind a Koenig, Quickstepper trying to react, but it's van der Poel who's going here. And van der Poel, just as he did in Dwars door Vlaanderen, just as he did in Brabant-Sappel, two races he won, has decided to go from a long, long way out. Meters maybe. There'll be a quick right turn, and then they're straight back into the town of Hulper.
I wonder if Izaguirre will actually work with Mathieu van der Poel. Look at the damage behind, look at the big gaps. The fissures in the group here.
Van der Poel looks behind, surveys the damage. I wonder what he's being told on the radio now.
I'd imagine his dad has put his head in his hands, to be perfectly honest with you. Saying, what is he doing?
If you attack,
you also know how you're feeling. You kind of know what kind of your reserve levels are. You know what sort of day you're on. So maybe this is just a preemptive bit of a strike. He's having a toot on his bottle now. It's going to get reabsorbed. This is going to come back together. But clearly van der Poel is feeling very, very good and certainly very frisky.
And we're coming back quickly. And now Alaphilippe is going to go.
Well, Devenage's job is done.
Alaphilippe onto the launch pad. And off he goes. This is Alaphilippe on the Ezer Bosweg now.
Well, this is anything that van der Poel can do. Well, I can do better. And goes clear again. 36.2Ks to go. I mean, look at the situation behind. You know, there's no real organisation. EF Education First are represented.
And Bora aren't going to chase because Sagan is out the way.
Yeah.
Dimension Data are there. Mathieu van der Poel's there, but he's got no teammates.
Well, Dimension Data. I really do not. And this is going to take a Herculean effort to now cross this gap with only 16.5Ks to go.
Valde is in this group alongside Lombrecht, who's at the front, the young Belgian rider from Lotto-Soudal. Madois, the man at the back, and of course, Mathieu van der Poel tried again to start the party. It was very impressive at the time. Didn't quite work for him today, but he is going to be up there on the result sheets very close to the top.
Certainly is. Looks like a solid top 10 ride for van der Poel. Big battle for the podium spots.
Well, they battle. And they battle behind, as you can see as well, because approaching the group we were just looking at is this lot. Valentin Madois towards the back. What a rider he's becoming, and really looking forward to seeing him at the Giro d'Italia on his Grand Tour debut next month.
Well, this is interesting. Jakob Fuglsang is not working.
On occasion after occasion, Max Schachmann might yet on the podium.
He's going to go straight
past. Kwiatkowski takes off in a minute. Kwiatkowski tries to take off and leave Trentin. He wants the podium assured for him.
Well, I think Schachmann's going to sit in the slipstream of Trentin. I don't think he even knows he's there. Just a little bit of a flick of the elbow. Shaking his head, big solo effort to get across. And meanwhile, 21 seconds. Alaphilippe, they've got a little bit of time to play with, but I tell you what, this is good riding by Fuglsang.
But if there's too many games up the front, you never know what might happen. It's been such an entertaining day at the Amstel Gold, and van der Poel and company are back. Oh, wow!
This is amazing stuff. 22 seconds, 1,300 metres. If they continue to ride cat and mouse, they're going to get the information of the car. Now Fuglsang is thinking, do you know what? I don't want to throw this race away. They're now doing this almost walking pace here, Rob.
He's lost his position now.
Look at them, nervous times. This is great stuff. Playing proper poker with each other. And meanwhile, the gap continues to plummet.
They're approaching the Flamme Rouge, and Michał Kwiatkowski, winner 4 years ago, riding for Team Sky, the Polish national champion, is approaching them, and he could be about to put himself forward as a candidate for a second victory. We've had quite an incredible day at Amstel Gold. There's the final turn. It's tail crosswind for the final K now, and it's Alaphilippe at the front. And they're about to be joined by a whole new group, and van der Poel and company might do it yet. What an exceptional day. Here comes Kwiatkowski. Left-hand side hits the front, and he's right back in the game. How did they let them do this? Alaphilippe behind. Kwiatkowski at the front, and Fuglsang in third place. 600 metres to go, but we've got a group of other riders still ready to go.
Kwiatkowski is now towing Alaphilippe to the finish.
400 metres. Van der Poel behind, Clark with him, Schachmann, Balde, Madois. There's Lombrecht, Trentin, De Marchi and Mollema, but it's the front three we're occupying ourselves with at the moment. This still could be anybody's. We've had one breathless finish already today. We're going to have another now inside the final couple of hundred metres. It's Alaphilippe who takes off on the right hand side. Look at Van der Poel going from behind though. Look at Van der Poel on the left hand side. Mathieu Van der Poel's going to do it. Mathieu Van der Poel, this is incredible. I have never, ever seen anything like this in my life. Mathieu Van der Poel has done it. This place erupts and Netherlands has a home winner. It's Roy of the Rover stuff for Mathieu Van der Poel. He was out of it. It was finished. It was done. It was never ever supposed to happen. But Mathieu Van der Poel makes it back, drives it on from a long way, and has pulled off one of the most incredible wins you are ever likely to see in the history of professional cycling. Mathieu Van der Poel is the first winner of the Amstel Gold Race from the Netherlands since 2001. It's been 18 years, and when he was 18 seconds behind, it looked like they never had a chance. They came back from such a long way. We expected drama and excitement today. We've had it. And just take that in.
Stunning. I've never, ever seen a finish like that in my life. Absolutely amazing. The thing is, Van der Poel drove that group for the last 2K on the front. He had Simon Clark on his wheel, six other world-class bike riders, led out, brought them back, led out the sprint, and won it. So powerful, prodigiously talented. This is the future of cycling, but I have never witnessed anything quite like that finish. That was a privilege to commentate on. Absolutely wonderful. I'm lost for words. Special, special moment.